It's a fine cloudy June day. It should be just about right for fishing a small loch just uphill from here. But first I have to get across this river without falling in. And then tramp over this tick-infested moor for a bit, avoiding standing on the snakes that live here. I have my own names for a lot of hill lochs, it's a kind of a secret coding system. I call this one the Viper Loch on account of the vast number of rattlers that live up here. Best to stay away from here, you're almost certain to get bitten. This is a dry fly only loch, it's just too weedy to fish any other way. Oh, there's a fish. Just a small one, but the fish in here are not big. Kind of breakfast size if you enjoy eating them. I don't, I just put them back. Try a few steps along. Oh, that's another one. I thought it was off there. It's a curlew calling. For me, that's the real call of the wild. There are lots of fish in here. I'm using barbless hooks, so not all of the fish stick. Barbless hooks and small fish with no weight in them means a lot of lost fish. That's a darker fish. There are big differences in colour from one fish to the next. Brown trout are really variable. The fly I'm using is a big cicada pattern. There's not a lot of wild cicadas in Scotland, but the fish don't seem to notice that. really easy to see on the water, so that's a big bonus. That's the best one so far. It's got a really big head on it. A real tiddler. My arm's getting sore now. It's a much lighter coloured fish. Time to call it a day, I think. It's a long way to go to get back. That was fun. Not falling in is a real bonus. Bike's still there as well.